bad nerd day at a party, man.
So this is where I'm up to. I've just pulled this case off. This little guy just sits in here like so, and it just, you got to move this around and bend the line, and it just hooks onto that. So just fiddle that off, put this to the side. I've got all the bolts the way they come out, because Harleys are recycled beer cans, and this one's like 87 to 90 setup, so it's probably been apart a few times, and everything works well, nothing's fretted, so I want to leave it that way. Now all I've got to do is, there's a thread, as you can see there, there's a thread here, and it just, you just got to unthread it out of this case. I'll thread the new one in, hook up my little doohickey to the doohwahi, and put it back together, and that's the clutch cable change. All right, what I didn't tell you, all this cable, this is the old cable, and it's just zip tied and it's going. But to do that clutch job, you gotta unadjust your cable. So lock nut, and then wind it up so that thread's not there. That's quite a long thread. So wind it so that's shut, and then that will give you room to get that clutch cable inside that case, which I've done. Cleaned it all, put it all back in, and just snugged up them bolts, just wrist tight. They are old, so don't go to factory specs at all. Just do it up nice and tight, wrist tight, and just in a sequence, and that's good. That's how I've always done them, and I've never had them leak, so do that. I use Penrite oil in everything I have, so just use Penrite gear oil in that, and that's exactly 1 litre. Does have a dipstick, so if it's, just check it by the dipstick, doesn't matter. With the adjustment, I've adjusted it back up. Now what I like to do, there is an internal clutch adjustment, which I will, you undo that lock nut, wind this Allen key out, do the Allen key up by hand, by finger, and as soon as it touches, you come back half a turn, lock that back up. I'll do that when the bike's running, so everything's sort of warm and I've used the clutch a bit. Now I will redo this, but what you do is this little gap just in here, all this is new and there's like little spaces, so it's meant to be a little bit grabby like that. About the thickness of a 20 cent piece is where you want that free play, that cable free play, like that. So that's what you want, about the gap of a 20 cent piece. So that's the play you want there before you start using your clutch. So all that's on, I've got the nice new clamp on the frame, I've got a little bit of clear vinyl like sort of sticker I sort of cut up and put on there to protect the paint. I'm not pulling this apart to paint the frame, I'm not going to pull it apart to paint the frame, so anything I do nick up on this frame was pre-painted a couple of years ago and then just sat away, so there's scratches here and there, but it's still quite mint. And like the quality of it, how smooth it is, it's all been cut and polished, and everything that's I've had to do, I'm just going to touch it up by brush and just leave it that way, mate. It's clean as. So clutch is done. Brand new brake cable, everything's braided on this bike because it's mint. With this brake, it was fitted up to that wheel with this, and it worked, but I've got to just skim off not even a mil, just off here, and I'll just do it with the flappy disc. See how it's got that little edge, that little sort of edge just there? I'm just going to skim it off to the flat. I'm just going to do that with the flappy, and it will just bolt back on there with brand new bolts, and then that will be the perfect spacer. Sometimes when you put these on, they actually just, you just got to put a washer behind them because they're too far that way, this way, this way. But in this case, the caliper's got to come towards me. So I'm just going to skim off there a little bit, and then that will slide in and bolt up, and it'll be perfect. So that's the clutch done. I'm very happy with that. Like I said, you can see it working. There's a rod that goes from here all the way to that cable, and it just pushes and opens the clutch up to stop the drive. Very primitive, but it's sexy as hell, so. Had to hold that in my mouth, I was hurt my jaw. Felt terrible. And strange. So that's gonna work fine. You can see I've got it in there. It's only loose, it's only in there loose, and it's still, it's good. I haven't even tightened it up yet, but you can see the black marker, just to give myself a bit of an idea where that bolt sits. I'm going to trim this down and then round this bracket off, and I'll do the same. I'll just round the edges off down the bottom, but that's looking good. So that's the guard done. Once I round this off, I think the indicators might come out of here. I'll leave that washer on there, put the indicators there. Those holes are getting used. I'll find something for these. Don't really want to weld on this anymore. So that's pretty much the rear guard done. Now, once I clean up these brackets, that'll be ready for paint, tank's ready. We're still gonna do this today. So I think I might move on to the exhaust right now. All right, so I got that on. That was actually a punish, I'm not gonna lie. These engines have been around since late 80s. So you can imagine how many times the exhaust has been on and off it. Studs in the head that come out, and they just get munted. And I was very cautious about putting the nuts back on and things like that. And I reckon I'm not even gonna take this exhaust back off. That's how bad it is. The weight, like you can see the way they are, the weight's already there. But when you start riding it, it's just taking the pressure off all the head studs. So that's where I'm up to there. Just give that a good little weld, a little clean up, and that's the exhaust fitted. And then I'm gonna go and put the front guard on. And I just gotta find a hole to put for the brake line P-clamps. I've got these genuine Harley P-clamps, and they hold the front brake line into place as it snakes sort of down into the front caliper. So that's the next job. So while I'm gonna weld the exhaust, I thought I might as well weld finish off this guard, just do a couple of spot welds underneath. That'll finish it off. Might just chuck another couple in here and there. And then she's done. She's ready to paint. So, well, ready to start getting it cleaned up anyway. Okay, let's get it done. Yeah. All right, I just threw a couple of little welds on there. I'm not sure if you can see it. And then, just don't know if you can see it. Where am I? Yeah, just couple little welds there, and that's all it needs. I like the exhaust, how it comes down and gives this all my ignition area in the Evos, your actual ignition is in there. And there's a line for it. When you start heating them up, they start missing and carrying on, you can burn out your whole ignition. So that's coming together. So what I need is to find a hole, put a hole about here for that peak lamp. Just like that. That's fine, that's not kinked, that's nice. It's tucked up behind that guard. It's got a little bit of dog leg. See, what I'll do is I'll probably bend that around like that a little bit and tighten it just to get off that. Doesn't scratch the paint. But that's looking good.